As a dog lover, I see the film as an homage to dogs. It's just, you know, I've seen it twice now. And the first time, I think I was just overwhelmed and in awe of the meticulous detail and the kind of exquisite production design and mise-en-scène that, to me, is like Wes. And then last night I watched it again, and it's like, you know, it's strangely emotional, like really emotional. The extent of a dog's capacity for loyalty and compassion, and their what they suffer for us, and the extent to which they are willing to give their lives for us is just really moving to me, especially now that I've been away from my dog for over a week and a half. I miss him very much. Part of what I love about Wes is, you know, it's really not so much about funny voices as finding some level of truth in the voice and some sense of humanity of the person who's reading it. So it wasn't a lot of affectation or acting. And I think because he gets the voice first and builds the character after, it's really interesting because you have this very sort of unique and specific human characteristics that he then attributes to animals. The detail in the puppets alone is amazing, and then those sets. And then on top of that, the obvious and beautiful references to Kurosawa, Japanese cinema, and, you know, like Uzukiyo wood carvings and paintings and Japanese landscapes, is to incorporate that all is an incredible juggling act. And I think part of why I love the film so much. It's really remarkable. It's really a feast. For me, the most profound message in the film is how worthy of our love our dogs are. And I guess that's something that, you know, maybe touches me in particular. I love all of the other elements of the film, but what happens between a dog and their master is an extraordinary thing, and I think Wes plays at it beautifully in this film. No, my sons have, but my dog hasn't seen the film yet. No, he did not. He's not a big into TV. There are some dogs who love TV. Woody couldn't be less interested in TV. I think it actually pisses him off.
There
you go. Yeah, he doesn't understand why people just sit there staring at the blue light. It doesn't make any sense to him when there are socks to be chewed and other, you know, incredible things to do.